posing as Vera Harvey, the singer, whose stolen car was used by the payroll bandits, Brenda attempts to trace the missing vehicle and get a line on the gang. Unaware that she's being led into a trap, Brenda follows instructions which lead her to a deserted warehouse. Chuck is covering her.
Are you the man who was waiting to see me about a car?
Are you Vera Harvey?
That's who you're expecting, isn't it?
Well, through the yards, take the second door on the right, and you'll find what you're looking for.
Pesky can't even remember his own name correctly. If Brenda would only tell me where she's going, these things wouldn't happen.
You can say that again. It might save us all a lot of trouble.
Oh, Miss Brenda ain't scared. She's told me plenty of times she knows it's dangerous, but she's got to get the news.
Now look, Pesky, think hard. Try to remember. Brenda and Chuck left to investigate a tip-off they got about a stolen car being returned for a certain amount of cash, right?
Right. Miss Brenda said she thought it was a big story about crooks stealing automobiles and then tipping off the owners where she could find them. Boy, was she excited. You know what she...
Yes, yes, we know all that. But where did she go?
Well, now, wait a minute. Let me see. You know, I think it had something to do with a front street.
There's no such street. Now, Pesky, open up that thick skull of yours. Let's try again.
Let me see now. You know, I think the name of that street had something to do with being all wet.
All wet? Oh, it couldn't be Water Street, could it?
Yeah, yeah, that's it. Water Street, number 214. 214 Water Street.
Are you sure about that number?
Well, of course I am.
214 Water Street.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That would be 412 Water Street if I know you at all.
And when you find Brendan, Chuck, send him back here at once so I can fire him.
I'll help you.
Say, how about a bonus, Pop?
You weren't killed.
If it hadn't been for that staircase, I would have been.
The position of Brenda's car tells me she's somewhere in this block.
Better radio in for more cars. We'll throw a blockade around the neighborhood.
I guess that was the last one.
And this is the first time I ever had a woman do my shooting for me.
It's Larry and Tim.
And this is the first time I was ever glad to see that guy.
See if you can get around behind him.
Right.
Tarp off him.
Boy, did I get him.
Oh, what a big help you are.
Oh, my head.
Oh, gee whiz, Timothy, I'm sorry. I didn't know it was you.
Oh, that's all right. So you're the dumbbell who slugged me.
Now, wait a minute, Tim. Don't lose your temper.
Stop fighting. I've got more important business to tend to.
Now, see?
Well?
Whatever you've got to say, you can keep it.
What's this all about? Come on.
All right. Vera Harvey called me. She said she got a mysterious phone call that her car was here.
Oh, so you're a newspaper reporter. And you fell for an old gag like that? Look, child, that one smells a mile away. Did it ever occur to you that actors and entertainers are always trying to pull some gag for free publicity?
This wasn't a publicity gag, Larry. Two mugs thought I was Vera Harvey and tried to kill me, didn't they?
Ah, you just happened to run into a bad neighborhood, that's all.
All right. You believe your little publicity story. I'm going to run this thing down. One of two things has happened. Either I ran into a racket where they tip off owners of stolen cars, or Vera Harvey isn't just a bird in a gilded cage.
Well, what do you know? Brenda Starr, the great detective. Oh, I can see the headlines now. Reporter nabs gang operating stolen car racket.
Very funny, Mr. Farrell. Well, the police commissioner won't find it so funny when he finds his lieutenants letting the press clean this thing up for him.
I'm going to let you in on a little secret. You should have called Papa before coming down here looking for stolen cars.
So you could drive me over with the sirens blasting, huh?
No, we found Vera Harvey's car about an hour ago. And now what have you got to say?